Okay, it is Tuesday, October 5th, 2021. It is about 10:15 a.m. and about 70 degrees Fahrenheit. We're at the Missouri History Museum here in Forest Park, home of the 1904 World's Fair. So this was the first, I'm going to show you the other side of the building too eventually at some point, but this is kind of the first memorial to Thomas Jefferson, as you can see there. This was built in 1913 with proceeds from the World's Fair. The Jefferson Memorial in Washington, D.C., that wasn't built until about 1943. This also coincided with we hosted the 1904 Summer Olympics, one of only three cities in America to have hosted the Olympics. Atlanta and Los Angeles are the other two. We had the first African American competitors and medalists in high jump and hurdles. And a bunch of food was introduced, so we're going to see all kinds of things inside there. Okay, so here we are again in front. Now this shows St. Louis suffrage banners here also. I probably should have showed this a little better earlier. Here's the fountain in front. And there's some more banners over on this side. The St. Louis Suffrage section of the museum. And I should have gotten this sign earlier here. STL Rocks. And I agree, it does. Okay, here's another spot on the outside that's showcasing the music. I'm going to show you another one. This shows the sounds of St. Louis. These pictures on the outside here. All right. Thank you. Okay, there's the Spirit of St. Louis. Now that's a replica. They used it for the movie in the 50s. The one he actually flew is in the Smithsonian in Washington, D.C. Thank you. That's the Great Fire of
Yes.
Thank you.
Oh yeah, now this is good stuff here. Scott Joplin. This is the best. His home is a National Historic Landmark. I'll be going there sometime. There he is right there. Here's the into some good stuff there. Here's Eugene Field. The Field House is also a National Historic Landmark. Eugene Field was a poet and children's author, and his father was a lawyer for Dred Scott.
Are these real?
This is good stuff here. Scott Joplin. This is the best. His home is a National Historic Landmark. I'll be going there sometime. There he is right there. Here's the Chuck Berry. Getting into some good stuff there. Here's Eugene Field. The Field House is also a National Historic Landmark. Eugene Field was a poet and children's author, and his father was a lawyer for Dred Scott.
Yeah. Thank you.
Cahokia Mounds section for kids. Isn't that something? There's Monk's Mound. And that was 120 mounds. This tells about Chunky. Quote by Nelly, huh? Scott Joplin.
Thank you.
Tina's popular. I could barely sneak in to see her.
What time are you using? Yeah. Okay, so we get 6 and 6. We get some trumpet players over here. Trumpet players like Miles Davis, who grew up in St. Louis, Clark, Tara. We're the years that we did something that was hard. Yeah, I guess he's like Chuck Berry and Johnny Johnson. Some of you might not know that Chuck Berry is the name of the author of Rocky Roll. Looks at a few types of music you may be familiar with. It looks at St.
Here's the other side of it. But here we are at Forest Park. Okay, I'm gonna wrap it up right there. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks.